That took me lots of time to figure out how it works, so I thought to share it. That's a starter's tutorial, and I will demo the whole process, together with this sweet anime voice. I will create a very simple animation, and I will include a 3D object and a texture that we will dynamically import later on our template. Press F on Spline Editor for easy in and out. That's our final animation. It doesn't do much, but it is a good demo for creating a template. Now select all the nodes you want to use in your template. We don't need the input node. right-click on any node, it doesn't matter which one, and select Create Macro. Actually, I'm gonna delete that to show it properly. Here we see all our selected nodes, and we can choose properties that we'll be able to directly modify in our template. We obviously want to select title modifiers, like changing the text and color and size. Also, I will select the background properties, so we can change the background color. You will see later how this works, so don't worry for now if it doesn't make any sense. Most importantly, we need the material input so we can change the texture on the 3D surface. Save it in your home, and we'll move it later on a proper location, because Resolve File Manager is politely an epic failure. We are done here. Close it and let's add our template on a directory that Resolve can see it. Basically is under .fusion that was auto-created when we installed Resolve. Open Resolve again, and now we can use our template. The template can have multiple inputs and outputs, and we can create chains of animations with macros, but I will keep it simple for now. So this is how we use the properties we exported before in our template. And if you remember, I didn't save the project before, because it doesn't matter. We can edit our macro and add more stuff. And then, they blame Adobe After Effects for having a slow previewer. Look at this thing. And it isn't even some heavy animation.